Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Frontier series, a global collaboration between Reuters Plus and KPMG. I'm your host, Lydia Tudor, and today we'll be focusing on tech to learn how the latest generation of AI is disrupting the very sector that created it. I'll be joined by two KPMG leaders and a specialist from Microsoft to deconstruct this complex topic. We'll start in Seattle in the US with KPMG's global head of TMT, Mark Gibson. Hello.
Nadira, great to see you and great to be here today.
Let's start with the human element of this technology. How will the role of professionals in this sector evolve?
Yeah, I think it's a great question. Hopefully, those routine, mundane tasks that a lot of tech professionals are faced with will start to subside and the technology will help in that area. I think very tactically, tech professionals are going to need to become more proficient on data. How does data work? What are the sources of data? They're going to certainly be programming in new languages that are starting to come out today and more will come in the future. They're going to need to understand machine learning and AI and those new emerging topics more so than ever and more than they do today. So those are the tactical ones, but I also think equally as important, tech professionals are going to need to develop skills that are much more intangible. I think creativity, the ability to be a continuous learner, to adapt to much more fluid situations, less construct in the way they do their daily jobs. They're also gonna work across departments, across parts of the organization that they might not have a lot of interaction with today. And you see sort of end-to-end, front office all the way to back office. So unique intangible skills, not just the specific technology skills, I think are going to become more paramount for the success of a future tech professional.
As well as responsibilities to their employees, tech companies are in an interesting position as both the builders and consumers of this technology. What strategies have been deployed to balance these competing demands?
Yeah, I love this question, and I've talked about this in my role leading the technology practice for KPMG globally quite a bit over the years. And it's never been more present than it is today, that these big tech companies, they're both verticals within the technology industry where they need to adopt these things inside their organization. But they also have a huge horizontal play across all of the sectors. You're seeing them partner with companies from healthcare, banking, insurance, and energy at the forefront today. So that horizontal role they play is really unique and really what sets the tech sector aside in this topic of AI. Within the walls of their organization, they need to be early adopters. They need to be the innovators and the ones that are encouraging their employees and their partners to be investing, to be using these tools, to become experts in them, to be the client zero for all of these products. And that will help build and position their tools, the innovation, the agents, the things that they're building to have more credibility in market and to work across those ecosystems.
And given the speed of development on all fronts, what should tech companies be doing to ensure transparency and address algorithmic bias?
Yeah, that's a really key question, isn't it? You can, no matter where you look, you certainly run across the issue of trust. And I think it does come down to trust. Whether it's in personal relationships, professional relationships, business relationships, those that we trust are those that we want to do business with. And so this emerging technology has put the issue of sort of trusted AI at the forefront for these companies to consider. So we're seeing tech companies do some very tangible things around open sourcing their technology, being very transparent in the way their models work. We're seeing them do bias audits where they're actually having third parties come in and test their data and their systems for the bias that you're asking about. We're seeing them conduct modified cyber attacks on their own systems. And then on a bigger picture, we're seeing the tech companies build what we often call a trusted AI framework. And we work with a lot of companies at KPMG to help them build What are the ethics around building an AI framework and putting a piece of AI technology into the market? How do you have it values-led and human-centric, and to build that trustworthiness that you really need to be a partner for others and to be a key strategic part of someone else's business that they would trust your tool and your partnership with? So great question. It's really, really important today. And I think the tech companies that are going to succeed are the ones that are really focused on that trusted AI positioning of their product.
Let's bring in Lydia Smyers, Vice President of the Americas Northeast Region at Microsoft, who's also in Seattle. Lydia, hello.
Hi, Nadira. Great to be with you today.
What do you make of Mark's advice on the steps companies can take to advance their AI transformation?
Well, Mark's focus on ROI is absolutely the right one, and we really agree. Establish the metrics, execute your milestones, and manage your outcomes. And then do that in a continuous loop with a true focus on ROI. That is really the way to get the outcome that institutions need today.
Now, Microsoft is at the forefront of AI integration across its enterprise offerings. How is the organization helping customers navigate the balance between open source and proprietary AI solutions?
Well, there's so much for customers to navigate. Of course, there's open source versus proprietary. But my goodness, there's build versus buy. There's choices like large language model or small language model. I mean, there are many, many questions. And ultimately, what we're thinking about at Microsoft is not a specific tool or specific point choice, but instead, we're focused on putting billions of dollars in R&D into what we like to think as a platform that can be the foundation for all of the tool set and the whole AI architecture for an institution. And that cloud platform of Azure is one where we're putting tremendous focus on to actually have open source and proprietary models available to our customers.
As Microsoft continues to expand its Copilot offerings across the enterprise stack, how are you helping organizations move beyond the enable phase to truly embed AI into their workflows and value streams?
Well, enablement is absolutely paramount. Modern AI capabilities can really enable and unlock a whole new production function. This production function is going to generate different efficiency outcomes, different scalability outcomes, and a true parting of labor, expense, and actual ROI. AI needs to be brought to not only every function, but also every capability, because ultimately, we see a world where AI, the fundamental outcome that it's delivering, is improved GDP. And this is societal impact at a broad scale where we see the opportunity. So at Microsoft, we are going first by function, HR, legal, finance, and DevOps, applying AI to every process, every capability, and then measuring the outcomes.
Autonomous systems and agentic AI are gaining significant traction in tech and other sectors. How can organizations ensure human oversight remains central to the decision-making process?
We also agree that human-in-the-loop is an essential paradigm. In fact, this is truly inherent in Microsoft's mission. Our mission is to empower every person and every organization on the planet to achieve more. And achieving more in the world of AI actually means realizing that GDP growth that we spoke about earlier. We see a flat population growth ahead, and we understand that that knowledge worker is going to be important to scale the productivity so that we can all really get to the abundance that we seek. So fundamentally, our framework of agents plus co-pilots plus human ambition is how we see human in the loop as a foundation. Frankly, agents on top of our co-pilot architecture, our framework with our identity backbone that provides a compliant and secure environment, that keeps humans in the loop and allows the human ambition to be the guiding North Star for what institutions are really achieving.
Mark, I'm going to ask you the same question. How can we keep a human oversight at the forefront of decision making?
Yeah, I love the answer that Lydia gave to that question, and we agree at KPMG with the importance of having humans in the loop. Earlier, we talked about trust, and I do think this is an area where trust is key. Having these ethical, trusted AI frameworks that companies follow that have human-centric oversight will help build that trust. I think you lead with values, you have humans in the loop, and I think you'll get the trust that you need to really have these tools be accepted in the market, to be trusted in the market, and to get the ROI that we talked about earlier, to actually achieve that ROI. So as we consult with our clients at KPMG, human in the loop is very, very real. It's a big part of our trusted AI framework that we work with companies on, and it's one that I think is going to be critical in building the trust that's needed in this area.
Finally, I'd like to bring in Anna Scali, partner, international tax and TMT lead for KPMG in EMEA, who's in Dublin, Ireland. Anna, hello.
Hey, Nadira, how are you?
I'm very well, thank you. We heard Mark suggest that tech professionals will need to develop their knowledge sharing abilities. What are the most effective strategies to overcome data silos that you've encountered?
Okay, yeah, data silos are a real challenge. And what are data silos? They are information or data effectively held in different parts of the organization, legacy systems, different business units, etc. And unless data is all pulled together and working together, it's very, very difficult to get the best insights from that data. And so having your data in silos can be a real problem. But European and global companies are facing that challenge at the moment. And there are a number of things that they can actually do to break down those silos and try and integrate their data. So a couple of things that they're doing as we speak. Number one, a number of them are using automated data tools, so AI tools that actually automate data and pull data together. And AI can actually be used to do that process, which is super. They're also looking at intelligent data cleansing systems, so taking raw data and actually polishing it up and cleansing it so that it is useful for AI models to interpret. Cross-functional collaboration is also an important one here. So it's not all about just getting the tech right. It's also about getting teams collaborating and happy to share information with each other. That's important if you're to pull all of your information together and have one source of truth, because I think that's what's really needed. You need a good, consistent data and one source of truth if you're going to be able to use it to drive, you know, the best insights that you can from an AI perspective.
Once we've established that single source of truth, then, how can organizations best use AI to augment their employees' capabilities?
Well, I think that that's a really important point. People can often be afraid of AI, but I think what we need to do is to start thinking about it in the context of AI is there to help and assist. It's not there to replace us. And so there are many, many ways in which AI can actually help organizations and workplaces and workforces. And I'll just give you three, I suppose, key areas where AI can assist. One is probably in the whole area of personalized learning and development. We all need to continue to learn and develop through our careers. And one really easy way where AI can actually assist is that they can actually, it can identify skills shortages, can identify courses and match them up. So personalized learning and development is a really great area to focus on within organizations and trying to bridge that gap between humans and AI working together. AI is also really, really efficient in sifting through information. So the second area it can be really, really helpful for is efficient decision making. So it can sift through information and do calculations a lot faster than we can. And the third area I'd cite is probably enhancing collaboration and communication between us humans. So for example, productivity tools, some of them are great at writing emails, translating language on the go. So much easier to collaborate maybe with our colleagues and frees us up to spend more time as humans engaging with each other and building relationships.
Looking to the near future then, Anna, how might AI reshape the tech industry and what disruptive innovations should companies be preparing for?
I think AI has emerged really as a pivotal force. And it's going to change both the tech industry and, I would argue, every other industry across the globe. It is transforming businesses as we speak. It's going to transform how they operate and how they innovate, which means it's going to have an impact on right throughout organizations, tech or otherwise. And I think we're on the cusp of a revolution here, right? Never has technology moved so fast, and never has it been so, I suppose, pervasive across all industries. I do think the tech industry has an important role to play here, because they're probably client number one for a lot of the AI that they are developing and is being deployed. And I think that's important, that they're developing it in a way that they can showcase to their clients. So I think AI has is really, really important in the tech sector, but really important that the tech sector are using it and showcasing it to their clients as well. I think it's going to play a significant role though across all industries. It's going to support decision making, change business models, change the way we view risk, change the way we innovate. So I think it has a critical role to play across all industries. But I also think it has a critical role to play in society. And that's really, really important to all of us, that as companies innovate, change processes, services, and use AI, I think it's important that they do it in a very ethical and equitable manner. And so that as we innovate into the future, it's not just companies that benefit, but AI benefits society.
Thank you, Anna. And thanks, Mark and Lydia, for your insights too. That concludes our exploration of AI in the technology sector. Do join us again for another episode of AI Frontiers.